Liquor sales are rising in the United States as people are turning to alcohol to cope with COVID-19. Joining me today to talk about this is Dr. Sudhir Kumar from India. Thank you so much for joining me today.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for having me here. And I'm privileged to be part of this show.
How are things in India?
See, fortunately, India is much better if you look at the numbers of United States or many of the European countries like Italy, UK, Spain, and Germany. So far we are doing better, much better. But, you know, we started about 2 or 3 weeks, you know, behind United States and maybe 1 month behind Italy. So the next 3 to 4 weeks are very crucial for us. As of today, we have 13,500 patients who are confirmed to have the disease. We are a little behind, you know, those countries.
Well, I hope, you know, things do get better, just like here.
Yes.
So let's talk about alcohol consumption, because we've seen and we see all over social media, people are drinking more and the sales are up. So people are consuming a lot more and they're saying that this is to help them cope. Does alcohol consumption really help people cope, or does it make things worse, like create more anxiety and panic?
Yeah, definitely it doesn't help them cope. What happens is alcohol is a CNS depressant. So once somebody takes alcohol or drinks, then it suppresses many of the brain functions and, you know, the areas of brain that make us think or make us worry. So temporarily they get suppressed. So when the person is under the influence of alcohol, they may feel that, you know, there are no worries and nothing. But the moment the effect wears off, the anxiety and worry is going to come back. So what I can say is that it's an artificial method to reduce anxiety. The effects are transient and temporary, not going to last long. And then they need to drink again to get the same effect. So this could lead to dependence and, you know, on alcohol. And we know that if somebody is dependent and, you know, drinks a lot, then there are many adverse effects on various parts of the body that could start. On the other hand, what is more meaningful, you know, most parts of the world today, they're under lockdown. We are not able to socialize and meet people. So what could be done is, you know, there are many hobbies which many of us have, like it could be singing, listening to music or painting or doing exercise at home, yoga, meditation. There are
definitely
so many other
better things. Than drinking.
Much more than alcohol. Yes.
Right. Now, does alcohol consumption help kill the virus at all?
Definitely not. I think what has happened is, you know, people have heard so much about sanitizers. And that, you know, those sanitizers that have 60% or more alcohol, they kill the viruses. So they assume that if you drink it, it's going to kill the viruses inside us. But that's not true, because, you know, the most of the alcohol that we drink, they're 30% or 40%, whatever. And then they get quickly metabolized. You know, they go to liver and, you know, other body tissues. So they're not, and the viruses are there in our respiratory system, in our throat, in our lungs mostly. So there is no, you know, it's not that we can drink and, you know, clean our system of viruses. That's not true.
Now, some health experts are urging people to boost their immune system by taking vitamin C, vitamin D, taking zinc. Consuming alcohol does not boost your immune system, right? That has the opposite effect.
You are absolutely correct. See, the alcohol by itself, it lowers our immunity. Because alcohol, as we know, it can lead to nutritional deficiencies. And I see many patients who have, you know, because when they take alcohol, they don't take good nutrition. You know, most of them will just get, because that has calories. It's called empty calories because it doesn't give you vitamins and other nutrients. So overall, the person ignores their, you know, nutritious food. They drink more. So they are prone to nutritional deficiencies and immune power reduces. So that's just the opposite happens.
Right.
And you talked about the supplements, this vitamins, even there are no hard data on that, but at least those vitamins will not harm us because they're water soluble.
Not drinking it at 10 o'clock in the morning, like you see on social media.
Right.
What about for medical purposes? Because here in America, the liquor stores are open and they are considered essential. So a lot of people were saying, oh, that's because people actually use it for medical purposes. Is that true or no?
No, I think the truth is not the complete truth. See, alcohol is required in many of our preparations. If you look at the composition of many of the drugs, especially this cough syrups, and some of them, they require some amount of alcohol, and also to make sanitizers and other things. But that doesn't mean that alcohol, what we use this, you know, this wine and beer and those things, they are the essential drugs or essential things for us to consume. So it's definitely not essential. Now, looking at the medical use, some people are dependent on alcohol. And if we stop that alcohol suddenly, they can go into what is called alcohol withdrawal syndrome, where they can get agitated, restless, and then at the some of them can get even fits and convulsions. Now, for those patients also, we don't need to give them alcohol. There are different strict protocols are there where we give them drugs like, you know, benzodiazepines, diazepam, and certain other medications, hydrate them. And then the trick there is to get them off, wean them off alcoholism, not to give them more alcohol. Only place where pure alcohol is given as treatment is methyl alcohol toxicity. In India and some other countries, we have spurious liquor where normally people consume methyl alcohol, but if we have more of methyl alcohol, recently you must have read in Iran also, somebody suggested to them that if you drink alcohol, will kill the viruses. So hundreds of people consumed what was methyl alcohol, and many of them died, and it can lead to blindness also. But if somebody has got methyl alcohol toxicity, there we can give alcohol to neutralize that. But other than that, there's no medical use.
You said some people actually died?
Yes, that was Iran. About a few weeks back, it was in the news. So I think some of their leaders, religious leaders or somebody, they urged their people that, you know, as like what you mentioned just now, that if you drink alcohol, you know, and it went on in the social media and WhatsApp messages. So many people received the messages. They even fed their children this alcohol, which was supplied to them. And unfortunately, that alcohol was not ethyl alcohol, which is normally consumed in the form of liquor. It was methyl alcohol, which is toxic to the body. And because children, you know, for them, the amount of dose required is, you know, much lesser. So hundreds of people died. Actually, it's there in the news. And I was very sad to read them.
Dr. Sudhir Kumar, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. It was a pleasure talking to you.
And thank you for joining us for this interview of Positive Parenting with Paula. I hope you stay safe and stay home.